Module 5, Part 2, Integrate Content with the Power BI Client API. Hi, my name is Peter Mines, and I will now demonstrate how to use the Power BI Client API to achieve client-side filtering and adding a context menu item. In this first part, I will demonstrate client-side filtering. In Visual Studio Code, I open the index file, and then I add another div element to the page. This new div element will present a drop-down list to the user, allowing them to select and therefore filter the report by a single demographic value. Notice that the first option represents all demographics, which means no filtering should take place. I save and close the file. Next, I open the embed.json file. At the very end of this file, I add an event handler. The event handler will be responsible for filtering the report page. You can see logic in the function that tests whether the all item has been selected. If it's been selected, then filters are removed. Otherwise, the specific demographic filter will be applied. I save and close the embed.js file. Now it's time to test the app, so I press F5 to run it. I now notice the demographic drop-down list presently set to filter by all demographics. I go ahead and open the sales analysis report, and then I select the sales trends page. When I hover the cursor over the column for January 2020, I can see that total sales were about 3.1 million. And yet when I filter, and I'll select the advanced demographic, I can now see that the report is updated. And when I hover over that fourth column again, I can see that the sales are now only 600,000. In this second part of the demonstration, I will now show how to add a context menu item. So back in Visual Studio Code, I reopen the embed.js file, and then I scroll up to the function that embeds the report, and then here in the settings, I'm going to extend them by adding in this logic here. This extension adds a context menu item with the title Show Value in Alert Box. It targets the column chart visual in the sales trend tab of the sales analysis report. And note that that visual name value was actually retrieved by using another client-side operation that reports on all visuals found on a report page. Next, I scroll down to the end of that function, and then I add some additional logic. This logic is an event handler that will respond when the context menu item is selected. I go ahead and save the file and close, and then rerun the application. I go ahead and open up the sales analysis report, and then select the sales trend tab. Now when I right-click on any one of those columns, I now see an additional context menu option, Show Value in Alert Box. When I select that option, the web browser notifies me of the selected month and value. I click OK to dismiss the message, and then I switch back to Visual Studio Code and stop running.